Kathy Lane Novak, and I'm here to invite you to participate in a special gift from God. It's a closer relationship with Jesus Christ. The gift is received by participating in our St. Charles Adoration Chapel. It takes very little time, and it's easy to do. Yet, by participating, you can fulfill Jesus' greatest longing, and that is to begin a deeper relationship with you. Why do I call this a special gift? First of all, as Roman Catholics, we know Jesus is physically present in the tabernacle of every Catholic church in the form of the consecrated host. We know this because he promised that to the apostles in John chapter 6. And then he carried out that promise at the Last Supper, found in Matthew 26, Mark 14, and Luke 22. So as Roman Catholics led by St. Peter, who was commissioned by Jesus to lead his church, we know he is physically present at every tabernacle of every Catholic church. However, there is a difference between his real presence in the tabernacle and in the Adoration Chapel. In the chapel, the consecrated host is fully exposed, meaning you can physically see the consecrated host. So Jesus waits there for us in a very vulnerable state. That's why we want to make sure he is never alone, and why Adoration Chapels around the world want at least two people with Jesus at all times. St. Charles has received many blessings, even miracles, through the Adoration Chapel. However, we need more adorers willing to spend a holy hour each week with Jesus, which is the reason I'm here. Through that commitment, you can show him how thankful you are for everything he's done and continues to do for you. But in the end, you'll be the winner, because through that holy hour, Jesus becomes a very close friend. The chapel is located in our ministry center, where Jesus is available to everyone during office hours. However, for security purposes, only assigned adorers can enter the chapel at any time. If you become one, you'll be given what's called a key card, which gives you 24/7 access to the chapel. If you're a night person and feel drawn to become an adorer, I have a special request for you. The night hours from 10 in the evening to 6 in the morning are the hardest to fill. So if you're willing to consider those hours, we'd really appreciate your help. Becoming an assigned adorer opens an exciting relationship with Jesus, and you can decide how often and when to visit. It's also up to you as to how you spend that hour. It can include anything from spontaneous or written prayer to simply sitting with Jesus, relaxing, and enjoying the sweet peace that comes from being in the presence of God. You may not feel worthy to spend this intimate time with Jesus, but he loves you exactly as you are. In his eyes, you are a beautiful child of God, and he has loved you from the beginning of time. It's why our Heavenly Father sent Jesus to die on the cross for our sins, past, present, and future. And it's why Jesus lovingly agreed to do it. Now he waits in the chapel for that precious time with you. But there are no strings attached, because his love is unconditional. He's simply inviting you to spend one holy hour a week with him, for you to get to know each other better. And he promises he will be there, waiting for whatever time looks best for you. But remember this, whether you decide to commit as an assigned adorer, or you cannot commit for personal reasons, either way, Jesus' love is eternal and unconditional. He loves you, period. I can tell you from firsthand experience that Jesus has been waiting for that closer relationship with all of us for quite some time. If he is speaking to your heart right now through my talk, close your eyes and listen to his holy words. Long have I waited for you coming home to me and living deeply our new life. Can you spend one holy hour a week with him? When I asked Jesus what he would like me to say during my talk, these are the words that I heard in my heart. Just tell them